Well, ladies and gentlemen, we have come to the last part of our program here. And thanks very much for actually being patient until I could say something, a word or two. Well, my job is to actually say thanks to everybody really here. Well, the only worry that I have, because as I was looking at people presenting here, sitting in couches like Brian and Sangeeta right now, is that I might lose stuff to SABC, you know, because now it's like they are presenting TV shows here. You know? Even Victor, you think that it's this guy, Kolani Kwala, doing his show. Yeah. Thanks, because it looks like you have done well. That's why you even appear as if you are actually presenting the TV show. Now, first, let me thank you as our guests, because you have made this successful. To have all of you here and all these chairs filled, you know, it has quite been a satisfying feeling on us to see that happening. And we know you have made so many sacrifices. You come from far away, KZN, some of you Eastern Cape. And it's particularly to KZN, I'd like to specifically thank Cocta in KZN, because in a very short space of time, they managed to mobilize about 26 municipalities to be here, you know, with us here. So really, thank you very much for that. Well, Madam Krishnan, if you achieve your objective of having 20% of your municipalities with clean audits, we'll claim some credit from that, because you were here. Thanks again for that. And of course, to the company that sponsored, in other words, bringing people here, we actually thank you them as well, because it is through them that we have managed to see so many numbers of people around here. To our speakers, well, our speakers, we do have their CVs in here, so I won't go on to mention them and mention their credentials and so forth. You can read those in your spare time. But really, we appreciate the practical value that you have given here in terms of helping people to be more effective in their audit committees. And really, the good attendance that you see here can be attributed to good speakers, because in the previous 2 years, we've had similarly good speakers, and the reason we have people here is because from the previous years, they've seen the value that these conferences do, and they decided to come again. And also, you haven't disappointed us. You've made good presentations here, so that even next year, we can still expect to see more and more people coming, because they know there is value here in these conferences. So thanks very much for your preparation, for the presentations, and for openly sharing your experiences with us here. I mean, here there were even role plays and everything, so there's a lot of preparation that went with it, people practicing, and I should think they had scripts, you know, like movie stars acting, you know. But, you know, their personal experiences obviously added, because they were acting something that they normally do as well. And from that, really, we gained a lot of things. I mean, you see the two-hour session here of the things that were covered in the audit committee. And even though some of us are experiencing going there, and some of the things that you listen to, that, yeah, yeah, now I'm learning, because these are some of, you know, strategies and things that are, that maybe you may have overlooked, you know, in your participation in the audit committee. So really, that hasn't gone unnoticed. To our speaker coming from Lesotho, Mr. Muhlori, or it's Muhlori's name, is Mr. Mpaka. Thanks very much, sir. You've driven a long distance. You even had to go through the border gate and produce your passport. You know, so really, that is a big sacrifice for you to honor this event here. So even when you go back home, please convey our thanks to your department and to the minister and so forth. We really appreciate it. And now the reminder that really the impact these audit committees have is far-reaching, you know. You can imagine, we didn't really think of SADC when we were thinking of audit committees. we're more thinking of our entities here and achieving clean audit reports and so forth, you know. But we can see this accountability goes far, you know. So really, that reminder, you know, has been helpful, and also to have, you know, some experiences from across the border. Well, there were many highlights here that one can mention. I'm not here to actually do a summary of these things, but I can resist some of these things, you know. When you see how, you know, they articulated this combined assurance, you know, it was yesterday. Really, it was quite an eye-opener for me. And then they even show how risk management can be mapped and so forth. And I particularly enjoyed when they started talking of the defenses now. The first line of defense being your internal controls, your management, and so forth, you know, to show that this thing doesn't start and end with audit committee. It's a whole process that is happening, you know. Second line of defense, you know, being maybe the internal audit and so forth, and the third line of defense being external assurances. You know, that was a real eye-opener. Now, it shows that we're talking about a process here that starts really from the beginning right up to reporting. And now, as the responsibility for you and me, who are in audit committees, now is to make sure that those things are happening. Yes, you're not there to look at everything that is being done there, you know, but through questioning, through probing and so forth, and through taking people to task, that way you manage to get people to do what they are supposed to do. And the whole accountability line, you know, there is actually being implemented there. So really, those were practical things that one can take in here. And then Adrian, in his keynote address here, talked about, in summary, the attitude also that people should have on audit committees. I must say, you know, the very first time I was audited, unfortunately, in my case, it was SARS that was auditing me at that time. So really, being an auditor myself and so forth, you know, I kind of looked at these guys that they are coming here, and I, you know, I tried to, in my mind, keep my dignity that I'm not going to be answering everything. They must go to talk to the finance people here, there, you know. And now you end up having some issues that are not cleared, that could have been easily cleared, because all you are doing, you are chasing these people away from you. And some, they even get afraid of you, because when they come to you, you are kind of impatient, you know. You're talking rough, and you're trying to get rid of them as soon as possible, you know. Now, what happens later, you know, they make a wrong conclusion, they come with these things simply because you didn't give them the answers. Now, it takes so long to try and unravel all those problems that have come. Unfortunately, with SARS, when they make those wrong decisions and whatever, they come now with this huge assessment. Now you have to start to fight this assessment. I know it is wrong, you know. And you realize that these are things that I could have easily cleared, you know. Well, that was a learning point for me, I must say. Now I'm so nice to my auditors, you know. I make sure that I answer whatever queries they have and so forth, and you become accommodative. So really, I take the point that Adrian, although he was talking about the audit committees, being a CEO, being an executive within an organization, now here are these external people being audit committee members. They are coming here, you know. Now, to look at them as, okay, now this is just to comply with the regulation. I don't really need these people. They come with suggestions, what do they know, you know? And you kind of undermine them. And then what happens? Problems happen, you know? So really, I think, although he didn't put it as humility on his side to actually listen to outsiders and take that into account and whatever, he put it as being smart, you know? So really, that's the attitude, really, that we should have, that yes, you've got independent people here, external. They come, they might say something that you don't like, they answer questions that are uncomfortable. It's fine. Listen, take into account all those questions and those suggestions, and if change is needed, you do the change. If explanation is needed, give the explanation. That way, at least the audit committee will sort of work smooth. Well, there are practical issues that we're faced with South Africa really is two worlds. You know, one guest did say that to me, that it really shows that we're in two worlds here. You've got people talking about yes, listed companies with all these sophisticated things and how audit committees are run there. And you've got institutions like the municipalities right there in rural areas where they are practically no people, when you look at it, no people to actually handle these audit committees, which really is an unfortunate thing. Of course, efforts are being tried to address those, you know, so that something can be done there. But the reality is that really there are even more challenges there. Now, if you have listened, I think Ayanda here mentioned some challenges even here in Johannesburg. Now, this is a big metro, biggest metro in Africa. Also, it has some challenges. Now, how much more will a company, an entity there in Ladysmith and in some other rural areas, how much challenges would they have there? You know. So really, these are the realities that we are faced with. But you know, I'm reminded now, yes, I've had the solutions that were put on the table there, but I'd like to just add something, because I just had somebody one time just making an example how sometimes complex problems can be solved with easier solutions, you know. He made an example of a gym, you know, where people were, okay, people go to gym and they take a shower and so forth there, you know. So they are running this gym, and then the problem is that they had some expensive shampoos that were used in the shower there. So these shampoos were supposed to be used by many people. But the tendency was that when somebody is there in the shower, he uses the shampoo, takes the bottle, closes it, puts it in his bag, goes. You know. Now only one person uses that shampoo. Now the implication is that to the gym, this is very costly. Now he said the manager here was trying to find a way of actually economizing here. He's thinking, they tried all sorts of strategy. But of course, they have to respect their guests. They can't search them to make sure that they don't, you know. They put all sorts of notices that, no, use it and leave it there. But it was not working, you know. Now, one guy that is a cleaner there, the manager saw this guy, and he was obviously worried, and this guy just said, why are you worried? And you tell him what his problem is. And this guy said, no, it's easy. What you do, you must just put these shampoos, open them, take the lid away. Somebody comes in and showers, you can't take it and put it in the bag, you leave it there, you know. So this thing was actually just by that little strategy, you know, little solution, you know, they managed to solve the problem. You know. So where am I getting at? Yes, we've got shortage of skill down there, that's a fact, you know, whatever. Guess what, where do I come from? Umtata, where does he come from? You know, maybe Ngelin, where does it come from? Nyandin, you know, all these places, all of us here, you know. The fortunate part then is that, you know, African people, they've got these two homes. The parents' home, they call home the parents' home, you know. Their house, they don't call it home, you know. So every now and then, what do? Come December, rural areas, you know. Now, if they are able to do that, why can't they chair those audit committees there? You know. So really, I think the point is that let's try to recruit from the people around here, make sure that all the knowledge that they have here, because they like going home anyway, they must go and do something now, not just to watch the cattle and whatever, you know. So that's my piece of a simple solution to to this problem. Anyway, ladies and gentlemen, really, I think the conferences like this are helping so that all these ideas now can be brought up here and, you know, even something that we didn't think of, you know, can have a great impact towards what you'd like to achieve. Well, one of the highlights that we want to think is the launch of this book, The ACE Model. You know, so really, it will go a long way to actually help in giving these tips, you know, to people, so that even in when you've got some time, you go through it again and just remind yourself of some of these things. So really, we really appreciate the launch of this book, and really another round of applause now to the authors, Cindy, for actually writing this book and making sure that it's available for use. I must say, as a big brother, I was always skeptical of this book. Hey, when did you start being an author, man? Just leave this thing, you know. But as usual, she didn't listen to me, and she was right, you know. So there is a book, ladies and gentlemen. Let's make sure we actually make use of it. Now, to the organizers of this event, this event, we really need to take a head out to them, you know. Cindy being the brains behind it, and all these role plays that were done and so forth, you know, just put those together. And of course, our partners that were assisting him in actually doing that, bringing all the practical experience and the uncomfortable things that they've seen, you know, in the audit committees, you know, trying to put that together and bring a conference like this is really commendable. And he has really brought in some practical experience and that one can use. Now, also, let me thank also the participation of you as the audience here, because with all these questions that you're putting through, it's actually compelling even the presenters now to think and to sort of package the information in a manner that you can actually apply back home. So really, we'd like to thank you for that. Now, of course, the support staff that has managed to put these things together. Yes, you saw these speakers toying at one time, but they were there to actually, try to make them to work again. So thanks for that. And people, all of these things like the banners and everything, you know, the support staff that actually did this, we really commend them because they really sometimes work so long hours to try to make sure these things actually done and accomplished. Right, ladies and gentlemen, once again, let's give all of us a big round of applause for this. Well, at this time, I have to ask Victor to come back to stage. And it's time to go home, Victor. Don't keep us very long now. thank you. Sorry, one thing I forgot, the CPD hours. Those that need CPD hours, you can claim 16 hours for this conference. So now, if you don't have your email address written in the registration forms there, please make sure that you do, so that we can email the certificate. You know. So 16 hours is a lot, ladies and gentlemen, because as you know, we need a minimum of 20 hours per annum. So with 16, you are only left with four now.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I shouldn't be saying anything after the chairman. Protocol doesn't allow that. We don't speak after the chairman. So, and I like that he summarized a lot. So that's what I was going to do. So I learned to delegate upwards and you learn these things. We don't have any other choice. The world out there needs us. Our companies need us. Let's use our expertise to make our companies successful. When our companies succeed, you had Adrian Gore, our countries succeed. When a country succeeds, the SADC and the EACs and the COMESA succeed, Africa succeeds, the world is a much better place. We create much more security for our people, we create stability. But as I opened with my story about my knees, once everything was uncovered, and she was no longer going to give up the child for adoption or do other horrible things, she gave birth to a baby boy, and she had the nerve to call him Gift. And I now she's attached to this little boy. But the point I'm trying to make is the very discomfort you create with your audit committee checks and this eventually yield very, very precious and positive results. So don't be scared of the discomfort you might be creating. Don't be scared to ask the questions. I still don't get it, what you auditors do. So I don't have any 16 hours here to take anywhere. But I thank you very much. Congratulations again for the book and everything. As they say, those in the know, it's time to go. You don't have to go home, but you can't stay here. Thank you.